Soonam Narayan and I'm pursuing BA LLB from UPES and I'm in my fourth year. The topic for today's video is Rajasthan Camel Prohibition of Slaughter and Regulation of Temporary Migration or Export Act 2015. Now, I will be discussing its important features and the sole and before beginning this video, I'd like to say that the sole purpose of this video is for educational purposes only. So let's begin. So the act says that the act is mainly to safeguard the camels and to ensure that they don't go extinct or the animal rights are not being violated. Now let's begin. So as for the act, camel meat means flesh of camel. What does camel mean? So camel means an animal of camelus genus. Now, code here means the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973. The competent authority is defined under the Act as the collector of a district and includes any other officer who may be authorized in this behalf by the state government by notification in the Official Gazette to exercise the powers and perform the function of the competent authority under this Act or the rules made thereunder for such area or areas and for such period as may be specified in this notification. The Act gives also the definition of word export. Export means to take out of the state of Rajasthan to any other place out of the state of Rajasthan. The Act further defines the term famine and scarcity affected area. Now, it shall mean an area affected by famine or scarcity in respect of which a declaration has been made by the state government under an appropriate law by a notification in the Official Gazette. Now, slaughter means intentional killing by any method and for any purpose whatsoever. Also, as per the Act, the term transporter means and includes in the case of a goods carriage as defined in the Motor Vehicles Act 1988. The owner, if the booking is undertaken under his instruction or with his knowledge, or the person for the time being in charge of the vehicle, or the person for the time being in charge of booking of goods or livestock. All right. Now, the managing director, executive director, general manager, or executive or the chief executive or any other business in charge of business as the case may be when the bookings are undertaken under his instruction or with his knowledge. Now the partner in the case of partnership firm, if the booking is undertaken under his instruction or with his knowledge. Now when we talk about the railway goods train, then in that case, transporter will be the person for the time being in charge of booking of goods and livestock at a railway station, or the person who prepares railway receipts at a railway station. Now, when we talk about the transporter, then it will include also the consignee to whom the livestock is to be delivered, and in any other case, the person carrying or accompanying the livestock. Now, the Act gives the provision for the prohibition of slaughter of camel. It says that no person shall slaughter or cause to be slaughtered or cause to be slaughtered or offer or cause to be offered or slaughter any camel. So in any sort of manner, the slaughter of camel is prohibited under this Act. Also, the Act further states that prohibition of possession, sale or transport of camel meat and camel meat products. It states that no person shall possess, sale or transport for sale or cause to be sold or transported camel meat or camel meat products in any form. Now, the Act further states the prohibition of export of camel for the purpose of slaughter and regulation of temporary migration. No person shall export and cause to be exported any camel himself or through his agent, servant or other person acting in his behalf from any place within the state to any place outside the state for the purposes that it may be or is likely to be slaughtered. All right. Also, it states that the temporary migration of Tamil from the famine and scarcity affected areas of Rajasthan may be allowed by the competent authority to other states in India for grazing purposes under a valid permit in the manner prescribed and laid down. Also, if any person residing in any famine and scarcity affected area and desiring migration of any camel shall apply to the competent authority having jurisdiction over such area, stating the circumstances why this migration is being done, and it shall also state the number of camel and name of the state or states to which migration is proposed and the period for which the permit is required. The competent authority, after satisfying itself about the genuineness of the request of the applicant, may grant him a permit in the prescribed form and manner, which, among other things, may provide for affixing of identification mark before such temporary migration of camel is allowed out of the state. And in no case, the period of said migration shall extend beyond the month of August next following the date of grant of the permit. On return from temporary migration, the applicant shall inform the competent authority in writing about the number of camel bought back by him together with the explanation for variation, if there is any. Also, if any person does not bring back such camel into the state and also within the period specified in the permit, he shall be deemed to have contravened the provisions of this act. Now, the competent authority may issue special permit in the prescribed manner for export of camel from Rajasthan for agriculture or dairy farming purposes or for participation in an animal fair. And before granting such permission, the competent authority shall also ensure that such export in no way reduces the number of such camel below the level of actual requirement of the local area. Now, thank you very much. And in this video, we learn about the important features of the camel slaughter prohibition act. Thank you.